live and direct. It's Sway in the Morning.
Right here on Shade 45.
Yes, 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 ladies and gentlemen. Now, I say rise and shine, but the people we have here today have already established a legacy that runs thick and wide and long, HB.
Pause.
And, oh, easy. Oh, reel up, reel up. Come back. Reel up, come back, come back, come back. You know, and I give these guys a lot of credit for my man Telli right here, Slimmy Neutron.
Bang, bang.
A.K.A. Trapped in Morgan.
Yeah, bang, yeah. Bang.
Of Fame School are here.
Yay!
Fame School.
Come out and play.
Yeah.
But, you know, Telli, you guys have been a part of many projects,
yeah.
Including Ninja Sonic.
Yeah.
To me, you know, when you think about the dude, they, I know people don't like titles and they don't like categories, but for a reference point, you know, there was a movement that was coming up in New York City, and these guys spearheaded it, Heather B., and gave a lot of energy to a lot of artists who have gone to grow up and be big-time artists like Kid Cudi or
right.
Cool Kids or who else can we name?
Kid Sister.
But
Theophilus, London,
yeah,
all these
everybody,
guys.
Everybody, man, it's like one cloth that we all came from, you yeah. know. And it's good, man. I love it. I love seeing the evolution of what we've, you know, because when we was out, it wasn't easy, you know what I'm saying? It yeah. was hard being, like, different. When we did tight pants, niggas would look at us like, yo, man, what's up with y'all niggas, man? So it's like, to stick it through, we trashing sneakers, trashing venues, and just being independent and individuals, we kind of, like, it was hard. So to see it, it's like watching your kid grow up. So
yeah.
It felt good to see like the game and everybody just taking an independent approach and not giving a fuck what nobody thinks.
Mm-hmm.
They're the reason for the tight pants. Now, people always wanted to know where the tight pants came from. You're looking at it right here. This is he's the reason for the tight pants.
But what was the reason behind the tight pants?
Like, I just felt like it wasn't no reason. It got to the point where we was just like, you know, you don't want to say the cliche like white guys think they black shit, but it was just the whole punk theory. Shout out to Jaja, my partner, and then just sounded like it was punk. So punk, it's just like we skated around tight jeans. You know, they not like denim with it tight. It was stretchable, but it just was the whole punk thing. It was a feel, a lifestyle, and it went with it. Like just wearing your jeans tight, baggy jeans. It just, even now, like it's flipped around. When you see dudes in big jeans, to me, it look like, yo, dog, you need to slim your jeans up. It don't even look right. You know what I'm saying? Look better when your shit fit. Even if your OGs, if you look at it before even punk, like, with rap and anything like the big homies like in the 80s and shit, they shit was fitting, you know? So
yeah, Run DMC wore tight jeans.
Yeah, man. So it's just...
You know what I mean? So,
but they were kind of like, it had like a punk feel too if you really look at it. Yeah. Like, because like if you look at old Ricky Powell pictures and shit of like back when Run DMC and all them mm-hmm. was back in the days, they whole style was like really like fitted and mixed with a little punk shit too.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah. Because there was a big scene going on in New York.
Yeah.
Lower East Side, you know, Fab Five Freddy was attached. It was art mixing, you know, with rap, and it was the same similar movement to what you guys helped spearhead. And I'm not sure if people know that you guys were at the forefront of this movement. So when you see Lil Wayne wearing Jeggings, or you see Kanye.
Now, I ain't gonna hold you like the first South by Southwest I went to like six, seven years ago, man, I took like a bus down there and it was like only indie bands. It was indie bands and it was like it wasn't really no rap, maybe like a couple book bag niggas, but it was just mainly white people in bands. So me and Jaja with Ninja Sonic, we were like, and I remember like, you know, Hollywood Holt and Mano, they was like involved too, but it was like very few like black people.
Yeah.
So you would go down there and we watched it like when we was with Green Owl, we got a ranch down there, all our homies came down there and we mm-hmm. watched year by year how it evolved from being like independent kids just down there doing whatever to like now it's like a merger now between indie and like
the mainstream.
And mainstream.
Yeah,
so it's like, yeah we was, I'm shit, man, we leaders of the free world, man. We definitely spearheaded that.
It's mm-hmm. interesting because we were talking about Venus X.
Oh, yeah.
DJ Venus X. And,
that's our sister. That's
yeah,
my sister,
and she got the ghetto goth movement.
Yeah.
And then recently Rihanna dressed like her.
She took a lot from like Venus. When we started, like we were all a crew.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? All of us together were a crew together. So Venus is like my sister. We all grew up and we all went to like our different directions. But when she started ghetto goth, like I watched her evolve into who she is. And like, when she started ghetto goth, it's a big thing in our culture. So yeah, they look down and people look down at us and see us. And they don't understand, like, the best way, you know, imitation is not the best form of flattery. You know what I'm saying? And people mm-hmm. say that, but it's not. What it is, it's like, Rihanna should pick up the phone, make that call. She right there. She can reach out to her and be like, hey, I like what you doing. Let's do this. And that's how you keep the culture thriving, not just like taking a piece from a nigga and then like running with it, because then you taking food out of her mouth and her, like, she bust her ass. I remember like she looked for venues, put the people together, and it's like we all I tweeted not too long ago, like shout out to her and all, because we used to throw these shits in warehouses and and like DIY. Even when we do our stuff now at Fame School, there's no booking it, no people doing nothing for us. We get on the phone and make things happen. So when you take from us, it's like taking out of a nigga panhandling cup.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Damn. All right. Ooh, damn. All right. Telly's here from Fame School. Slimmy Neutron is here as well. I want to get to some of your new music and your new project. But before I do that, I normally don't do video cameos, have the beat, because that's where I'm at in life, unless it's special. And these guys approached me for a song they had called Mosh Pit, correct?
Yeah.
And they wanted to reenact, the video was based around the movie The Warriors,
right?
From back in the 70s. And, in The Warriors, it's a famous scene. Cyrus, this big-time gang leader, was trying to unite the gangs. And I guess, Telly and him saw me like Cyrus. Heather brought a tear to my eye.
And asked
me to play the part of Cyrus. And then I had Rich Nice on my side as my commander-in-chief in this video. You guys, go look up this video right now, Mosh Pit by Ninja Sonic, and I'm going to play it right quick, and then we're going to talk about the new music.
Nice.
That we shot that, how many years? Was that two?
That might have been like two or three years ago.
Yeah.
Feels like eight.
So I'm listening to this record we just played, and all I'm thinking in my head is, what do you guys' live shows look like? Because I haven't had the pleasure of seeing y'all perform. But I feel like it's probably something very different.
Nah, it's pandemonium, man.
Yeah.
Like punk rock, jumping in crowds. Got 100 niggas on stage, jumping in crowds. It's crazy because when we first started, they was like, you can't have all these niggas on stage. And now, everybody got niggas on stage. But jumping in crowds, mosh pits, going crazy, girls dancing there. It's nuts. It's like what it sound like, probably times like five.
So what do the girls look like? Because I feel like your groupies, a description of them, probably different from Rick Ross's groupies.
We don't want to call them groupies.
All right, the women that
friends,
come.
It's like, how can I say it? It's a mixture because, it's people that gravitate to our music are usually extremely creative. So it's a mixture, it's like a lot of art school girls, and you got like hood girls. Like it's a mixture. It's totally a mixture.
The down though, like getting head from a girl in their crowd is easy. That's not the problem,
man. People come out to our shows and want to have fun. There's no like I'm gonna go.
What did they say in the bathroom?
That's legendary.
My name used to be Bathroom Sex.
Damn.
And Ninja Sonic for like first 3 years in Ninja Sonic, my name, it was a nickname going. It was called me Banyo. My name was Bathroom Sex.
Not to say because
I had sex in the
El
bathroom.
El Banyo.
Because of what?
I was just such an the epitome of a party is fucking in the bathroom. So when I come, I'm like the life of the party. So it's like bathroom sex,
Let me in the bathroom. Another question, okay? Because I know when Danny Brown was up here and he was talking about how a girl came on stage and sucked his dick in the middle of his performance. Would you let that happen to you?
Ooh, anything can happen on stage, man. It's a party, man. It's a party on stage, man. You never know. That never happened to me, but I can't answer unless I go through it.
Can I go back to the bathroom sex? Do you know their names, or that's not important?
Sometimes, because it's like it happens so fast in the party, and it's just you just raging next to you in the bathroom, you hanging out, what's the name, it's like forget names, it's all about that experience, the memory of
what's in the name, right? So you're inside the stall, right?
I have a special move, if I tell everybody, it won't be special.
Telly, tell us.
Come on, move a new move.
Your name is Telly.
I've been retired for bathroom sex. You know, for a little while, man.
How long? Two months?
I'm just Pan. I'm Telly Pan.
Telly Pan. All right,
I'm
cool.
Peter Pan. I'm leading the kids to Never Never Land, man. Free world, man.
Yeah, because my daughter listens to your music now. I don't want her to hear this part of it. All
right. It was a time and a place, man. Like, if you was there, we were like, oh, God, we were like animals, man. We were really the Lost Boys.
You guys really, to me, empowered the DIY movement, the do-it-yourself movement. We got Charlos on the line from Atlanta. Good morning. How are you?
Hey, what's up,
What's up, fam? We got, go ahead. We got Telly and we got Slimmy Neutron K, Trapped and Morgan here.
Yeah, man, too. I want to say what's up to you gentlemen, man. You guys have paved the way for basically a lot of the punk rock, hip-hop type movement,
Thank you, man. I appreciate that.
hey, no worries, because one of my homies is Zach Coley.
Yeah.
And he had a band. He was in the same session with you guys, Ugly, out of New Jersey.
Yeah. Oh, you know? Oh, oh, shout out to Horror, the whole Horror in Jersey clan. That, those are my brothers, man. That's my brothers,
yeah,
man.
Homie. Yeah, yo, we've been trying to connect with you guys for the longest, man. The homie's still working and everything, but I just want you to know, man, thank you so much for just putting your music out there, keeping the shit live.
Oh,
man,
you make a nigga shed a tear, man. I appreciate you, bro.
Yeah, no worries, man. We'll see you at the top, family.
No. Hold on the line, man. We'll get your number. Write his number down for me, DB. Yo, Heather, before you do, I'm looking at Telly's watch, man. He's so not in tune with, you know, how we, he's on such a different wavelength. I'm looking at his watch and it says 3:55, man. It says,
yo, wow.
Yo, let me tell you something. Hey, let me tell you something. The watch is an extinct item. The phone replaced the watch and cable blocks has replaced the clock, all right? Okay. This watch was a gift from my homeboy. He has the same watch that the band with a Rolex on it, and I loved it so much when he went to New Mexico. Shout out to Wyatt, a good friend of mine. He actually bought the band and just threw a watch in it just so I could have the same band.
So it's not for time?
So, no, I should set it, but I'm like, it would take me too long to try to figure out the time if I looked at it. Like, I'm so not in tune with the watch.
He got a dead watch on his wrist, Heather.
Yo, let me set my watch, man.
Right at least twice a day, Sway.
Yeah, this nigga Sway, man. This nigga got a, he's on point. Like,
he noticed
everything, man. Let me get a mirror to make sure I got it in my nose. In my teeth.
What I noticed, why are you so quiet? Because to me, the quiet ones are usually sneaky. What's your deal? Do you have bathroom sex?
Slimmy Neutron.
Nah, sex or, well, what's your deal?
Nah, I get it popping too. You know what I'm saying? I was letting, you know, this is Ninja Sonic Movement, what we were just playing. I produced for Ninja Sonic. I did a lot of stuff for them. That's how we met, you know, me originally for years ago. And then this whole new thing we got going, Fame School, is where we're at now. You know what I'm saying?
But you produce for like mainstream acts too,
yeah,
right?
Definitely,
like,
man.
Mariah Carey?
No, not Mariah. I was with Corey Rooney. I was in a group.
Corey Rooney.
Yeah,
right.
Originally I was in a group with Sign the Kid Capri. We were uninvited guests. We were a rock group. It was like rock and hip hop. And then we ended up breaking up on tour, crazy stuff. And then we started a new group, Ferrari Snow Day, and we got signed to Corey Rooney,
who also worked with
Mariah,
J
Lo, Michael Jackson,
Destiny's Child.
Yeah.
All right. And then Fame School. What is, you got the project is called Level Up.
Yes.
Okay. Go ahead.
EP coming out. Yep. Level Up.
And then when is it coming out?
It's coming out June 17th.
All right.
We're dropping the EP and the store launch with our clothing and everything. And then June 3rd is the single coming out, RNS, which drops, the video drops June 3rd too.
Okay. Yeah. What is Fame School? Why? What? That's an interesting title. I know it's everything, right? It encompasses everything. Talk about that.
But Fame School is just like, It kind of came from like a joke. We were joking around in the studio one day. I was producing Ninja Sonic.
Yeah.
And he was like, yo, I'm bringing everybody here to be famous. You know, he was all cranked up, crazy. We were going nuts. And all Fame School turned into like, you know what? Let's just do this group and let's start it. And it moved from there.
And who are all the members in Fame School?
Me and Slim. Like, he does the production. I do the writing, you know, and it's us. But the thing is, it becomes like, you know, it's Fame School, just us, the core members. But it's becoming like a lifestyle. Everybody that's with us and roll with us and love us, it just became like, now it's just an umbrella.
It's Academy. You know what I mean?
It's Academy.
Yeah.
So can I get an honorary doctorate, for, you know, from Fame School?
Yes, you can. Yes, you can. We're going to send you your uniform, and you're going to be lit.
Thank you, man.
Tight jeans.
I'm
going to
get that. All right, let's play this RNS song, and we're going to open up the phone lines, 888-742-3345. Slimmy Neutron is here. Telly Pan is here.
Yep.
Call us. You did a remake of Juvie, huh?
Yeah, we had to, man. It just felt so right. We was in the studio going for it. We just said, let's do it.
Yo, I like that, man. I know Juvie. That's my dude, man. I'm going to tell him to jump on that remix. Hey, Blaze, what up?
Super legendary.
Sway, what's up, homie? How are you?
You doing all right, man. How you been, man? It's been a second.
It's been a while. It's been a while, man. They've been having me travel all over this damn place.
That's all right, man. At least you got something to do.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right. Say what's up to Fame School.
Yo.
Fame School, what's up, brother? How are you?
I mean, everything is good, bro.
Hey, man, I'm feeling that. I like that, bro. Keep doing what you're doing, man. I like it.
Thank you, bro.
Appreciate you, man.
Yo, Blaze is just like one of our longest-running citizens of Sway in the Morning right here, man. You guys got that movement.
Nah.
We got a movement too, Telly.
Nah, of course.
Yeah. Come on, man.
This is not a movement. This is like a life, like getting coffee in the morning. Like, this is a routine.
Yo, man. So, you guys jump. You go, you know, it's... I would just like to follow you around, be a fly on the wall one day.
Oh, no, you won't, man. You would get so mixed up in some mess, man. It'd get too crazy.
Where do you live?
I live in Brooklyn.
In Brooklyn?
Yeah.
And then this pays all the bills for you guys now? Or?
Yeah, well, you know, the Ninja Sonic's tech checks still come. And then this nigga, he's a maniac, man. He's like, he produces and he lives in the studio, produce and edit. Like, I'm going to let him tell you.
Yeah, man. Working with everybody, a little bit of everybody, you know, a little pub deal, a little, you know, like licensing deal.
Yeah.
Helps out, you know what I'm saying?
But it works out, right?
Yeah, yeah. We got some good records coming out, though.
Okay, that's what's up. How many days of the year are you on the road, would you say? Like, because the lifestyle I'm getting is this exists under the radar for many people.
Right.
But then there are many people, droves of folks that follow this movement. You know what I mean? And it's not something you're going to see on MTV. It's not something you're even going to see on Revolt or BET. Maybe Revolt, because they tend to dig a little deeper now. How many days are you on the road? Do y'all have kids?
I got kids, but it's like, yo, when duty calls, you gotta go, man. It's like you don't even look at it no more from the standpoint of like we coloring outside the lines, man. Like when we gotta go, we go. You know, we all over. There's no telling where you gotta go, especially with Ninja Sonic, man. We toured all over the world, and now we with this Fame School, we putting it together real right. Like so, it's like right now this is all the first steps, but we about to be out. Like we about like next month, we probably gonna spend a whole month in LA writing and then moving around, man. And wherever duty calls, you just gotta go. It comes with the turf, you know?
I dare to say, like, you guys' activity and the bricks you laid open doors for groups like our Future and the ASAP Mob and, you know, these guys that are coming now. Man, who kind of, right? Would they be considered second generation?
Yeah, of course, man. Especially like ASAP, those are the bros, you know what I'm saying? But it all comes from like it was individuality. What we tried to do, even on our own accords with me and Slim, it's been like individual. I wrote a song and then he added to it and we co-wrote a song without even knowing each other. It's always been, he's always been like rock and roll. I've always been punk rock. So the individuality, like, that's all we've always been doing. And what it was, like, a lot of times back in the day, people were scared to be they self.
Yeah.
Or they were like, rap has to be like this or this. Mm-hmm. You was backpack or you was hard. Now what we did was created this individuality. If you want to rap about, you know, your orange juice on the table or your favorite marker, you could do a whole song about that and nobody won't judge you, because it's like now we've inspired people to just be individuals. You know what I'm saying? Be like yourself. And that's what it always was. So, like, even Rocky, they try to hit him with this and that. It's like, yo, let that boy live. Like,
because of why he was dressing and all those things.
Everything. It's like everybody always got something to say. But it's like if you still walking around judging somebody, you're like, what you live? What the times are you living in? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is the...
Tracy gets that a lot.
What? Stop. Nah, you just got to ignore the hate. But I was going to say, because a lot of people look at this generation as very heavy on social media, that plays a part in every single person's music business. But when you go on social media with the power of being anonymous, you get a lot of people that are always going to be spewing hate towards y'all. So how do you deal with it? Do you ignore it or do you tweet back?
Man, ignore it.
Yo, man, let me tell you something about people.
Keep moving.
I'm a people. I love people. I love studying them, watching them, hanging out with them. Like, I've met too many goddamn people. I can't remember everybody, but I love people. And one thing about people, they gonna have opinions. Like, I can't. Like, I do it for me. Like, I'm blessed with the ultimate. I'm not the best decision maker in the world, but I know what feels right and wrong. And if it feels right for me to do something, it is right. And people relate to it. I used to tell people like this. Do you watch? Who watches hockey in here? Anybody? Who watch hockey?
Heather.
Heather, right? Who else?
Crickets.
Now you think now you think us not watching hockey affects hockey's profit or business or fan base?
Not at all. Everything affect me from stop watching it.
See what I'm saying? So so what I do is not for everybody. Right. If like when I do, like, one guy who just called, like, yo, you the homie, that made my almost cry, because that, like, thank you. You understand me. You know, like, we do it for the people, whether it be big or small, who understands and appreciates what we do. We do it for y'all, and that's it. If you don't like it, so goddamn what? Like, I've just heard country records for the first time today that I never heard, and it did 5 million views. So I don't think me not knowing it or don't liking it or not liking it affecting them. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Damn, I like that. Hey, man, I'm not here to judge you, but you are a rapper. Amongst other things.
So they say.
All right. And on this show, Heather, you know.
Talk about it.
On this show, when MCs come to the mic, man, you I ain't saying you got a show improved, but
I'm saying it.
Okay, there. Telli, Fame School, you wanted to drop a beat on them.
Hey.
Hey.
What?
Yeah.
Hey.
It's quiet for you niggas like sign language. Molly, wretches, high maintenance, instant gratification, no patience. Son of Goose, rider, baby, roller, Mercedes. The ride around on fire, you're getting bent. Team, fuck y'all niggas like 50 Cent. Niggas can't see me like I'm way intense. I'm way intense. Rolling, teeth grinding and sweating. Teeth grinding and sweating. I'm about to blow up, about to blow up. Bruce Willis in arm again. Niggas can't forget. Yeah, you're dealing with a veteran. And I brung some niggas that's real young nigga, and they love playing with weapons. Every old nigga that played me, and DJ that ain't played me, now that I'm buzzing in the bitches love it, it's like fuck you nigga, pay me. 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 It's feeling like it's the 80s. Niggas talking shit and they act like I can't hear. I'ma send my little cousin, he gon' catch him on the stairs and leave his ass right there. Leave his ass right there. You keep frontin' while you rollin', you gon' be rollin' in the chair. Damn of a dollar, man, I'm so cliche. Fuck coat seats, my next need more space. Most of these niggas is phony and faking. These bitches, they just wanna get in my way. Fuck sitting in prison, I'm living my vision. This Fame School and we here to stay, and we accepting financial aid. This for my niggas who can relate. If not, I care less, cause me and Slim are the best. Y'all connect for we are chess, and I'm an expensive mess. I go above and beyond, pardon me y'all, I just be venting when recording signs. Had to cut a lot of niggas off because cause I just wanna ball, I just wanna win, I just want the fly shit on my skin. Can y'all blame me, nigga? Can y'all blame me? I'ma go hard, nigga, I'ma go hard, nigga, I'ma go hard. Why I'm here, I'ma buy cars, I'ma buy crib, cause it was hard, nigga, get in here. And since we going, I'ma go off the top. Wonder my nigga, Slay is that dude. If you feelin' us, then here's what you do. Purchase our single on iTunes. Yeah, nigga, I was up all night with my nigga, I got in a fight. Then I woke up and missed my flight. Now the big deal, nigga, that was light. My real name, they call me Mike. Slim's real name, his name is Mike. Michael Mike, Mike cool night, black cough like NASCAR. You can ask God and he'll tell you, and none of this shit was written. I'ma go off the top and spit it so good with perfect precision. I got really bad vision, so I can't go see 3D. But I take my kids, love my kids, real nigga, real nigga shit. That's how I'm talking about.
Damn, that was fun.
You're listening to Sway in the Morning on Shea 45.